Oops, I guess I could do that too, sorry.
Three honeys to pigeon.
Remember to lift on your elevator, guys.
Did not remember that. Okay.
Eight jumps side to side and forward and back.
Do the twist.
Downward dog, push up, jump.
Whoa. And get that shoulder stretch. And you're trying to keep your legs together the whole time, buddy.
Eight handstand shoulder shrugs. Shoulder stretch. Switch. Overhead.
Yes.
Matt, I love that you changed your name.
What?
I love that, Matt, you changed your name. Oh. Sorry.
Four flamingos. Leg.
Queen Georgina.
I'm learning
things. I love it, Your Highness. I love it.
It is now the Georgian era. Georgian era. Not the...
Wow.
Yes, Daniel. Get it.
Oh. I would be fired as a flamingo. That was awful.
Okay, tuck tuck pike pikes. Hold. Right leg lunge.
Yes.
Straighten your leg. Slide.
Knee off it.
Rotate to middle. Other leg lunge. Straighten your leg. Slide. Okay, come out. 8 pulses on both sides, 8 R trips and 8 B ups. Okay, 8 ankle pumps, toe point, circles out and circles in. Okay, wrists on your own. Seal.
R.
Side. Other side. Pike. Forward torso twist. And then four. Okay. Bridge. Ready. 3, 2, 1, up. Come down. Okay. 4 high jumps, and then 4 tuck to handstand, pike to handstand. And we done.
Kind of an offshoot question. Why don't movie villains make the button green?
Not to tell you. Do you want to explain it to them again for those who are on Monday?
Were we doing body shaping stuff first?
Oh, yep, just kidding.
Was today the handstands?
Uh-huh. Okay. Can I highlight you?
Okay, I'm taking my shoes off for this one, simply because I think it'll be better for my walls. And yeah. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna do 2 body shaping things for handstands. Hopefully my computer doesn't die, but you're gonna need to move your computer to a specific angle so that Coach Des and I can help you out. Oh, sorry if things change. All right, there we go. Oh, I don't know if you guys can still see me or not. All right. So here's the angle we're going to need from the side and being able to see the wall. You might have to have your camera a little further away than you think so we can see your whole body. What we're going to be doing is we're going to go toes and nose against the wall. And then you're gonna pull your nose barely off the wall, trying to keep that straight line. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna start slightly switching feet so you're working on balance and that body alignment while still getting 1 foot to tap the wall for balance. So hopefully I'm not too tall and y'all can see this, or I'll just scoot it back further. Toes and nose, no ribs, nothing else touching, just toes and nose. Barely pull the nose up, and then 1 foot up. And you're just gonna be slightly switching toes while still holding that body shape. We don't wanna see any of this moving around stuff. Just barely switch your feet, toes and nose close to the wall. Did that all make sense?
Yeah, how many?
20 switches.
Can we start now?
Yes, please.
Oh, okay.
Again, watch and hear a word you said.
Tyus, was that you?
Yeah.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
So you're going to go handstand against the wall. Toes and nose will be the only thing touching the wall, and then barely pull your nose off so you're keeping a straight line. There you go. Alexis got it. And then you're going to be just barely switching feet. So you're trying to keep 1 foot in complete straight line, and your second foot just keeps switching to just barely tap the wall to keep balanced. Trying to do that 20 times.
Mm-hmm. 20 each foot or 20 individually?
20 individually. Careful, Lexus. Okay. Okay. If anyone puts a hole in their wall, I guess we'll do an extra video about how to patch a hole in the wall. I got to do one of those anyways.
Henry, point your toes on you.
Good, try to keep those feet quiet, you guys.
Wait. May I ask again? 20 altogether or 20 each foot?
Each foot. Sorry, 20 altogether. Sorry, just 20 switches and then you're done.
Okay.
Nice. Okay, we're going to do one more handstand one before we get on to the workout. This one, we're going to flip around so that your back is to the wall and your hands are going to be a little bit away from the wall. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be creating the handstand position that we use during contact of the back handspring. So it's going to be a really open-shouldered one. And what we're going to do is we're just going to open up into that position and then push back into a, essentially it's a poorly angled handstand. So.
Yeah, I'll still use the same wall. So feet are on the wall, hands are away, and I'm going to keep this straight line, and then I'm going to open up my shoulders like a back handspring, keeping my butt tight, and then I'm going to push back into that straight line. Open it all the way up, push back to that straight line.
Please, nobody die.
What was that?
How many?
Let's do 8. Be careful, you don't need to go too far. Just like a back handspring, this shape should not be starting to open up into a bridge. Just a tight, open shoulders. Don't let that booty sink down as you press those shoulders out. Keep that booty tight and going up.
Just open your hips and go out. Hips up.
I just have
Alexis, that cat just loves you.
I tried.
You did good.
I don't know.
Back handsprings with cat from now on.
Back cat.
It's done. You know, you look confused. You good?
Yeah. So I normally do this whole thing with two screens so that I can have that view up on the TV, which is why I'm always looking sideways. And then whoever spotlight I have on my computer, but I had to unplug from the TV to go do that. And now I can't get it set back up like that. So I'm all sad now.
Sadness.
Very. Okay, I'm working out. You guys ready? Coach says I do not have this one memorized.
Okay. The first one's elbows in, push up, shoulder tap, and then lift.
So it's push up, one.
And then on your stomach, lift, arm, yeah.
Chin stays on the ground. Arms up for a set lift. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna be going all the way up to either 10, 12, or 14, and then all the way back down to 1 in our 10-minute time frame. When we're doing the shoulder taps, This does double the shoulder tap, so that means it will go number two will be 1-2, and it'll be 1-1-2-2 before 1-2-3, and then 1-1-2-2-3-3.
And we also have to do 1-1-2-1-2-3 of the arch reps.
They're not arch ups, it's just the set lift, so it's just your shoulders doing the lift, your chin stays on the ground. But yeah, so this is just like the workout on Monday where we've got the pairing of exercises, and you do one of each, and then you go up to two of each, and then three of each, and then four of each, all the way up to either 10, 12, or 14, and then all the way back down to one of each in our 10-minute time frame.
Okay.
I'm so sad I don't have gallery view going too. It's going to hurt my soul.
All right, you guys ready?
What soul?
Here we go. 10 minutes. Ready. Set. Oh, wait, I forgot one thing. If you finish early and we're still waiting for those 10 minutes, same thing applies. You have your options of resting, grabbing some water, being ready for the next 10-minute round, or if you've got energy and you want and you're able to keep pushing. Today, what was that?
Lunch switches.
Yep, today's gonna be lunch switches, and that'll be the only option of just being able to go lunch switch as we wait for that 10-minute mark.
Wait, one more question. Elbows in push-ups?
Yeah. Yep. All right, here we go. Ready, set, and go.
I'm gonna out. this club, Katie.
Yes, it is. Melissa. Yes, I find you. Come on, Henry, keep it going, dude. Come on.
Yeah, Henry.
Halfway there, if you haven't started to down climb, speed it up. Nice, guys. Full push-ups. Get those elbows bending. If you're struggling, you can go to your knees. Let's see that full range of motion, guys. Minutes left, lunge jumps if you're done. Yeah, Thais. One minute left. Coach says I forgot the next two.
Slide me up.
Gotcha, we're doing the tuck ups as we switch both directions, right? Just one way.
I think we're going to side B up one way, roll to tuck up, and then roll side B up the other way.
Okay. All right, 30 seconds more. Next one, we're going to be doing those side B ups. We have your one arm out to the side, other arm up. You have your side B up. We're going to do the other side B up. And we're also going to add tuck up. So this one's got all three of them that you've got to do all the way up your climb and back down. More seconds. Same thing, 10, 12, 14. One jump, rest in, drawing in place, you're done. 3, 2, 1, begin. Good, you guys. Be mindful of that form. Keeping those legs straight. Toes pointed. Nice, Alexis. Good, Henry. Yeah, Katie. Dang, Melissa. Nice. Keep it going. Yeah, guys, come on. Keep it burning.
Let it burn. It burns so good.
Yeah. Wow, tuck ups have never been so hard. This is awesome. Yeah, guys. There's a halfway point. If you haven't turned it around, speed it up. If you haven't reached 10, really speed it up. Come on, we can all get 10s in.
Yeah, Katie, keep going. Good job.
Three more minutes. We can do this. Come on. Thanks. Gotta start picking bigger numbers, man. You're doing great. Minute and a half left. You got this, guys. Keep pushing. Keep burning. Yeah. Which days? I forgot the last one too.
Side leg lift, back, back. I think.
Oh, yep. All right. 15 seconds. What this is going to be 4-point position, leg to the side, one lift, other side, one lift. To the back, one lift, other back, one lift. Don't let that be our chapter. They should just be glutes doing that lift. Time starts now. One of each, two of each, three of each, all the way up. Oh, I normally get to five before it starts going crazy. Yikes. Really important to keep those legs straight, toes pointing, guys. That side of the hip burn though, holy cow.
On the back kicks, you guys don't have to pull your knee in if you don't want, you can just kick.
We are going to have the most powerful round off kicks and half out kick outs like crazy. Cool. We've got a minute left for that turnaround point. You can get higher numbers in there. Come on. There's your halfway point. If you haven't turned around, speed it up. Yeah, Coach Dennis, same. Come on, get that side up there. Don't let that foot get below your shoulder. Every lift. You got this, Alexis. Come on. Numbers only get smaller than here. Dang, Tyce, you got to start picking bigger numbers, man.
How you doing? Good?
And I'm happy
Done, guys. You got lunges in you. Let's go. Get that final leg burn.
Unless you got it.
Last minute. 60 seconds left. Come on, guys. You're not done. You can do this. Yeah, Maddie. All right. Yes, Queens. Yes. Ooh. Last 10 seconds. Come on. And done. Nice, guys.
Who wants to lead cool down? Rosie did warm up, so let's have somebody else lead that part. Any volunteers? Tributes? Don't all jump at it at once.
I will.
Who's that?
Yeah, Lissa.
Thanks, Liz. Appreciate it.
Roll down in the middle. Other leg. Same bike. Sitting pike. Straddle down to the middle. One leg. A leg. One leg lunge. Trailing no knee. Slide out. Other leg lunge.
Try your leg, Destiny. Slide out.
You're good, Alyssa.
Middles.
Get the mat.
Pigeon. Lean back. A leg. Lean back. Seal.
You guys are allowed to unmute and talk if you want.
Quiet. What's up, guys?
What's up, Rosie?
Hello.
Hello, Henry.
On Saturday, my family played Clue, but we got really tired. So the language just started devolving into random different words. And everybody just kind of started mumbling their answers.
That sounds fun.
This weekend I'm dyeing my hair turquoise.
Yes.
Good for you, Tice.
You're gonna send us a pic of that, right?
Tice, did I see you have a Tupac poster in your room too?
Do what?
Do you have a Tupac poster in your room too besides just the Marilyn Monroe?
I can't hear you.
What are your posters in your room?
Oh. That's Marilyn Monroe, Joker, that's Batman, that's
Claus. What's that last one?
What do you mean the last
one? The last one you further to your right, on your side wall? Is there one over there? What's the one that we saw while you were doing handstands?
Oh, Oh, this one? I don't know what it is. I thought it looked
cool. Do you know who that last one is?
No.
Cool. Sorry, listen. Sorry.
Oh, no, you're good. I think that's it.
Good job.
Cool.
For Friday, you guys are going to want to have a chair again. And you're also going to want to have a pillow. Why do you do this to me?
Chair, pillow. And make sure you guys are doing your visualization. We left it open-ended. Floor. Whoa, I almost said vault. Rod floor, double mini tramp. And then after a workout on Friday, share what you visualized and what was going on in your head. And we're going to be asking for details. Just like, I visualized backflips. That ain't going to cut it. Like, I actually want to know what went through your head. What were good stuff, bad stuff? What do you think you learned and made improvements on? Like, I'm going to be really asking. We're going to be really asking really, really,
really
big questions about what you were visualizing. So we really get to know what's going on in your head. Besides, I did flips in my brain.
I did flips.
Sound good, you guys?
Yes.
Cool. Take care. See you Friday.
See you guys Friday.
Bye. Bye.